Like buying new clothes? Don't worry, you're not alone. And shopping's never been easier. Fashion's gotten faster and more disposable. Every year, roughly 100 billion garments are produced, and the majority of them end up in a landfill within a year. And that looks about as bleak as you'd expect. But new technologies could allow us to trim that number significantly. Could they turn our towering heaps of discarded textiles into useful green materials and help cut down on this insane waste? And how hard could it really be to recycle old clothes? Good news for all the optimists out there. The fashion industry has boundless room for improvement, especially since the rise of fast fashion, which we outlined in this report. Roughly 10% of all global carbon emissions stem from the textile industry. It's also incredibly resource intensive, guzzling up roughly 90 billion cubic meters of water annually. That's 4% of global freshwater usage. And a lot more than water goes into producing our clothes.
Almost always, these materials go through heavy chemical processes to make them the way they are today, whether it's finishing, whether it's dyeing.
Priyanka Khanna collaborates with brands and producers to foster sustainable innovation in fashion.
Which is why it is mostly, even the natural materials aren't really biodegradable. And it takes sometimes over 200 years for these materials to biodegrade in the industry.
And that's a big problem because we produce a whole lot of textile waste.
In the US, textile waste has grown 80% since the year 2000.
Rachel Kibbe runs Circular Services Group, which supports industry and government in reaching sustainability goals.
It is our fastest growing waste stream. We send over 30 billion pounds of textiles to landfill every year in the US alone.
Most of our old clothes end up in landfills. What doesn't is frequently burned. Unsold stock and donated old clothing are frequently shipped to the global south for resale, such as here in Accra, Ghana, where 40% of what arrives is actually considered trash on arrival. The US sends more than 600 million kilograms of used clothing abroad every year, largely to the rest of the Americas, while Europe exports more than 1.5 billion kilos, with much of it ending up in Africa. Waste in these regions winds up being dumped, burned, or polluting oceans and waterways. Textile waste isn't just old, well-worn clothes that are ready for retirement. It also includes excess stock and the scraps generated during production.
Less than 1% of this material is recycled today, which means all of this is going somewhere.
When we collect clothes, they're primarily going to be sorted for reuse. That's the highest value. Some of those clothes may be downcycled into insulation. Some may be sold as wiper rags. And then a small portion can be mechanically recycled. But mechanical recycling has its limitations.
In 2024, mechanical recycling is the best option we have. And though chopping clothes up and spinning them into new fibers is way better than landfills, it often means a degradation in quality, and it's rare that such materials can be recycled again. But that could change soon. There are a bunch of exciting new recycling companies boasting new technology, battling for funding, and hoping to tailor a future for textile waste. Chemical recycling, where textiles are broken down to the molecular level and then rebuilt into a range of materials, is being touted as a better solution. While some companies only recycle cotton, Australia's Blocktex can recycle blended material, shredding waste and then chemically breaking down garments and separating polyester from cellulose, aka natural or synthetic cotton. Polyester is converted into pellets, which can be used for textiles or as materials in construction, while cellulose is turned into clay that has use cases in textiles, agriculture, and even packaging. The flexibility is intentional.
I would never want to be beholden for my outtakes just to one brand, because I know how badly those brands can behave.
Adrian Jones co-founded Blocktex in 2018.
We prefer Blocktex to have outtakes that can be useful to many rather than just be useful to one. And I think that's been a real difference for us. In the industry, everybody is preoccupied with making more textiles.
Blocktex recently announced an expansion of capacity to 10,000 tons a year. Berlin's Refresh Global also emphasizes flexibility. Using a biotech approach, bacteria breaks down and sanitizes textile waste, creating three raw materials: nanocellulose, ethanol, and sanitized textile pulp. Through Refresh Global's partners, these materials are used to make anything ranging from furniture to bike frames to ethanol-based cosmetics. Refresh Global is a newer company than many competitors and plans on developing a network of smaller facilities that can be developed quickly and flexibly with partners. That is a very different tack than Sweden's Renewcell. One of the world's biggest chemical textile recyclers, it was among the first to build an industrial-scale commercial textile recycling facility. Here, cotton textile was shredded into a slurry, separated from any contaminants, and then dried into sheets of what they called cellulose, circular cellulose, which could replace virgin materials like cotton, oil, or wood in the production of new, high-quality textiles. Going down to the molecular level helps maintain quality, and Renewcell said its cellulose can go through the recycling process 7 times. There were limitations, though. They could only recycle waste that's 95% or pure cotton, meaning lots of what's filling landfills wasn't eligible in the first place. Renewcell's recycling plant opened in 2022 with a capacity to recycle 60,000 tons annually and room to expand to 120,000. But there's a reason I'm using the past tense here. Though Renewcell's ambition made it a beacon in the industry, it wasn't rewarded. Renewcell shockingly filed for bankruptcy in February 2024. Just days before the announcement, Renewcell told DW they were recycling far below capacity and fashion brands were hesitant to fully commit to recycled materials.
We could be producing a lot more.
Trisha Carey is Renewcell's chief commercial officer.
Many of the brands have goals set for circularity, carbon reduction, traceability, water goals, a variety. So we are a solution to their goals. It's how quickly do they want to be able to achieve those.
Renewcell partnered with brands like Levi's to recycle production waste and include cellulose in their products. H&M became a shareholder in 2017, yet it wasn't enough to make the plant profitable in its first year. Renewcell called their bankruptcy a testament to the lack of leadership and necessary pace of change in the fashion industry. Renewcell's struggles highlight the challenges facing recyclers.
It has been something that has shocked most of us working on sustainability of textiles.
Teresa Domenech researches sustainability management at UCL.
The existing business models in which most fashion brands are nested, they don't really help for initiatives like Renewcell to really be able to make it.
While recycled materials mean less reliance on water-hungry cotton or oil-based synthetics, they're currently more expensive.
The challenge is scale. The challenge is really getting it out into the world in a way and at a price point that can compete with virgin fibers. And so we're at a key inflection point now.
Mechanical recycling has gained a limited foothold in the last decade, and innovation on the chemical side means there are lots of companies racing to scale up. But achieving profitability before widespread adoption is clearly a challenge.
Maybe it also says that we need a bit more support from government and public bodies to make these things work. We know that purely business-based disruption, they might not work in a system that doesn't have the conditions. We might need to help those pioneers through the first stages of development.
It's not just about getting the recycling technology right. Entire sprawling supply chains have to be adapted to accommodate new materials. Waste needs to be seamlessly collected, sorted, and processed, and producers and consumers all need to get on board. All of this requires hefty investment. An estimated 7 billion euros would be needed to scale up recycling to hit 20% of textile waste in Europe by 2030. And while there's plenty of VC cash woven into these startups, Renewcell shows a profit-obsessed fashion industry won't recycle out of the kindness of its heart.
There isn't enough push from the legislation side to force the industry to actually adopt these materials. So not that the industry should require forcing, but if it's going to be more expensive material, if it's a transition with the thousands of suppliers sitting in Asia, with all the brands sitting this side and across the world, it really does is a function of information, so them having access to everything, which is not easily done until legislation usually takes a role.
The EU has mandated that by 2025, member countries begin collecting textile waste separately, just like they do with paper, metal, plastic, and glass, which should improve on the 22% of waste that's currently gathered. Mirroring proposed legislation in the US, the EU is also mulling a rule that requires producers to pay for the processing of their textile waste.
We have to ensure that these laws don't just charge the producers for one portion of that puzzle, like just collection. It has to also facilitate the infrastructure for both reuse and recycling and the innovation around that.
As it stands, recycling isn't profitable. State actors could also set the tone by adopting targets themselves.
Recycling for recycling's sake is the nicest way to go broke really quickly. You know, because everybody wants you to recycle. Everybody wants you to solve their consumption guilt. But for us to be successful as a recycler, we have to have committed outtakes. And that's where government and private enterprise has a role to play in saying, you know, government particularly is very large procurers of products.
70% of textile recycling is currently mechanical, but that looks likely to change thanks to all the new chemical recycling companies on the scene. But really boosting our recycling rates depends on changing the industry's whole infrastructure, not just adding a couple new technologies. Things are currently so dire that recycling just 10% of global textile waste seems nearly utopian. And this will still just be a drop in the bucket if we keep producing insane amounts of clothing, which, depressing spoiler alert, is projected to actually increase in the coming years.
Recycling is still only one part of the problem. Our current consumption patterns cannot continue if you want to move towards a more sustainable industry. There is a huge amount of overproduction in the industry, and whoever's responsible for it, there's a lot of debate around that. Bottom line is that overproduction needs to reduce.
That 100 billion garments we produce each year means 14 for everyone in the world. If we can't convince fashion victims to stop buying their body weight in clothing, at least we can assure that as much as possible of what they purchase is recycled.
Well, I've done my part by having zero fashion sense and walking around in ratty old t-shirts, but what do you think? Can new recycling technologies help save the textile industry, or is it totally down to us consumers? Thanks a lot, and don't forget to subscribe. We've got new videos for you every Friday.